In this video, we take a look at the Confusion Matrix, a representation of a classification model performance. Here, you see an example classification model that predicts customer satisfaction for a fictitious airline using the logistic regression algorithm. The predictor columns contain passenger and flight information, such as customer type, type of travel, flight distance, and seat comfort. The target column is called satisfaction and has two classes, satisfied and dissatisfied. The scorer JavaScript node reports the performance of the classification model in its interactive view. Here, you see the confusion matrix reporting its performance. Let's take a closer look. Our example is a binomial classification problem, so the confusion matrix is a 2x2 matrix. The actual target classes define the row IDs, and the predicted target classes define the column headers. The first thing to do is to determine one of the target classes as the positive class, and the other class as the negative class. Assignment is arbitrary, but often the positive class refers to the class of interest, if there is one. We assign satisfied as the positive class and dissatisfied as the negative class. Now, let's take a look at the four counts that the confusion matrix reports. True positives are displayed in the top left cell of the confusion matrix. True positives are customers who are actually satisfied, which is the positive class, and were correctly classified as such. False negatives are displayed in the top right cell of the confusion matrix. These are customers who are actually satisfied, but were incorrectly classified as dissatisfied, which is the negative class. False positives are displayed in the bottom left cell of the confusion matrix. False positives are customers who are actually dissatisfied, but were incorrectly classified as satisfied. True negatives are displayed in the bottom right cell of the confusion matrix. True negatives are customers who are actually dissatisfied and correctly classified as such. To summarize, positive or negative refer to the predicted class, while true or false make a statement as to whether the prediction is correct or incorrect. To remember the distinction, there is a trick. If the count starts with true, then the prediction was correct. The correct predictions are on the diagonal. If the count starts with false, then the prediction was incorrect. The incorrect predictions are on the anti-diagonal. The confusion matrix can also report the performance of a multinomial classification model. For example, if we have three target classes, the matrix becomes a 3x3 matrix. Here, you see a confusion matrix for another classification model predicting customer satisfaction. This time, however, the target column satisfaction has three classes: satisfied, dissatisfied, and neutral. One of the target classes is defined again as the positive class. But now, the remaining classes define the negative class together. As before, we define satisfied as the positive class. Neutral and dissatisfied define the negative class. Here, in this cell, you can find the true positives. For the other counts, we need to sum up the numbers for the two negative classes. These numbers represent false negatives, these false positives, and these true negatives. In this video, we've introduced the confusion matrix for evaluating the performance of a classification model. Our confusion matrix shows four counts: true positives, false positives, true negatives, and false negatives, referring to correct and incorrect predictions of the target classes. The confusion matrix can be used to evaluate both binomial and multinomial classification models.